Hey everybody, welcome to episode 24 of All Ride, and today marks part two of Up Your Game skill series, and we're here once again with Chris Nixon at the bike park at Constantia Uitsig, and today we're talking everything cornering.
Okay guys, today we're going to look at cornering, but it's important for you to see our first episode on balance, because cornering actually comes from our hips. And to separate the two out, you need to look at balance first, because balance and cornering are two separate things. So just click on our card above here, have a look at our first episode, and then we can get onto the cornering. Okay, so we've done the balance, and the reason why we've done the balance is balance comes from your steering, and cornering actually comes from your hips. So because we've done the one now, we can then separate, and our hips are free to point in the direction that you're going to go in. And that's the real secret about going around the corner, is it comes from the hips. As soon as you point your hips in the direction that you're going, you're taking the mass of your body and sending it in that direction. It's no good coming into a corner, turning your handlebars, but the mass of your body is pointing in the direction. Bike wants to go this way, but your body wants to go this way. So it's important to think that your belly button is your torch, and you want to shine your torch to see where you go. And as soon as you do that, the whole mass of your body goes in that direction. And that's the basics and the fundamentals of really cornering. If you've got to drop a seat post, what happens? It's really easy to move the bike from side to side. If you don't have a dropper seat post, it's not a problem as well, because all you have to do is get your weight a little bit forward, lean the bike over, and it's easy to lean the bike from side to side. And then the other thing is, you always got to have your outside foot down when you go around a corner. And then all your weight is on the outside foot and pushing down on the ground, and because you're leaning the bike over, you're then actually adding grip, because your weight is then in line with your tires in the ground. If you go around a corner with your cranks level, what happens is your weight is more in line with the bike, and then your center of your weight is over here, which is fine, but you don't get quite as much grip as if when you have your weight on the outside pedal. So that exercise that we've just shown you is what we call the weaving exercise. It's about moving your bike from side to side, and the more often you practice, the better you're going to get. It's about teaching your brain to tell your body what to do, and it needs to be automatic. The more often you do it, the more automatic it becomes. And it's about doing it outside your house, in your driveway, a little bit every day, and as soon as you do that, it's going to become a lot easier when you're riding the trails.
Now that you've got the key principles in place, why don't you try it out in an actual corner?
So when approaching a corner, it's always better to brake early rather than later. Your brain is always going to try and protect you. So if you go into a corner too fast, you're going to have to brake too much, and you're going to slow down too much. So rather brake early, so your brain then says to you, I'm happy to allow you to go through the corner at this speed, and then you can ease up on the brakes. You never let the brakes go, you just ease up on them, and you can throw the corner through the corner much faster if you brake early. So now that you've got your braking right, you need to look at the line in which you're going to go around a corner. A lot of people want to take the inside line because they feel it's the fastest way around the corner. But what happens if you take the fastest way around the corner? If you look at this line, you cut the inside of the corner, and as you cut the inside of the corner, you end up having a tight corner over here. So you end up braking again. You brake back there, you're braking again, tight corner, and then you've got to really pedal to get back up to speed again. So a much better way to approach the corner is, when you're doing your braking, look at where you want to enter the corner. And it's always going to be much better to enter the corner on the outside of the corner, because then you're able to control your speed through the corner much better. If you follow this arc that we've drawn into the grinder, you can see it's much more flowing. There's no sharp corners in it, and it keeps your speed to go out the corner. This high G-out spot over here was where the most grip you're going to need on the tires. And you're going to keep that speed much better, especially through this point of the corner. And when you get to this point of the corner, you shouldn't be looking here anymore. You should be looking out the corner for any problems or any rocks that might be out the corner. So now that we showed you the correct way to go around the corner, let's have a look in practicality, and I'll give an example of the correct way to do it.
Thank you.
Just a quick recap. We've done the weaving exercise, and it's important to practice the exercise as often as possible. The more you do it, the better you get at it. And remember, we're training our brain. The other thing we looked at is the lines which you approach when you're going into a corner. Remember, the outside line is always going to be the fastest and the smoothest line through the corner. And then next time we're going to look at improving your confidence and the speed at which you go around the corner. So a bit of an exercise to help you with that.
Radical. So now I think you've all got some homework to do. Thanks for joining us for this episode 24. Keep tuned in, keep locked and loaded to the channel. If you don't want to miss any of the action, be sure to subscribe. Until next time, we'll see you later.